Think about how any traditional rocket works. It has a thrust chamber, closed to the front and sides, but open to the rear. When fuel and oxygen molecules are pumped into the thrust chamber, a strong explosion is created. The forces of said explosion gives molecules great acceleration in all directions. The force of the explosion expels the molecules towards the rear. As for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. The rocket receives an equal push forward. The problem is that by rapidly expelling molecules, we soon run out of fuel and oxygen molecules. This mass or molecule requirement is the limiting factor. If we close the rear end of the chamber, then our molecules do not escape. But the molecules give an equal push in all directions. We are not going anywhere. What we need is a method to make the molecules on the forward end of the chamber push harder than the molecules on the rear end. Now, how do we do that? Please observe this video.
Cambia la cosa. Entonces, en el caso anterior, porque el ventilador estaba sumando por los lados, incluso intentó moverse un poco para el otro lado, pero poco.
We have a torsion balance pendulum. On one side, we have an airtight box with a motorized propeller inside. On the other side, we have a counterweight. Inside the box, we put a propeller, a motorized propeller. What will happen when we turn the propeller on inside the box? This is what has happened. Inside the container, we have billions and billions of fast-moving molecules that are colliding with each other and with the inner walls of the container. On the front side of the container, we put the motorized propeller. When we turn the propeller on, its blades will collide with some of the gas or air molecules inside the container. When the blade collides with a molecule, it will give it a strong force that will give the molecule a high acceleration towards the rear of the container. As for every force, there is always an equal and opposite counterforce. The propeller will also receive a force, shown here as F2. Every collision will result in one of the molecules being expelled towards the rear of the container, and the propeller being pushed a little bit forward. Therefore, exerting a force against the inner front of the container. What happens to the momentum of the molecules that were thrown towards the rear of the container. If they all were to arrive uninterrupted, they would transfer the same momentum to the rear of the container and the container would not move. But on their journey to the rear of the container, they collide with billions and billions and billions of molecules. Each time they collide, they change direction. No momentum is lost. Only the vector of the momentum is changed. And by this incredibly simple method, we can make a container push itself from the inside without expelling molecules, and this changes everything. From simple satellite positioning to deep space exploration and our first visits to Alpha Centauri, a new age is starting now.